Hello friends, myself Tushar Ugale, Assistant Professor, Department of Agril.Entomology, K.K.Wagh College of Agriculture. Today we will see the laboratory rearing of the Corcyra cephalonica. It is a laboratory host for various parasites, beneficial insects. Corcyra cephalonica is a cosmopolitan major sturgeon pest known as the sturgeon pest all over, across the world. It mainly attacks on the rice grain, feeding on the store grain, especially rice, jowar, bajri, and wheat. Including the groundnut, all cereals are the secondary host of this pest. Corcyra cephalonica is commonly known as the flour moth or grain moth. It is also commonly known in India as the rice moth. It is a native to tropics, but it also survives in well condition in warm climate. But temperature areas survive in the heated stores. Systemic position of the Corcyra cephalonica, phylum Arthropoda. It belongs from class Insecta, subclass Pterygota, division Endopterygota, order Lepidoptera, family Pyridae, and genus Corcyra, species cephalonica. Sorghum, wheat, and rice are the major host for this pest, which can be used for the laboratory rearing also. The life cycle of the Corcyra cephalonica completed near about from 1 month to 1.5 month, near about 33 to 52 days. Life cycle is complete type of metamorphosis, holometabolous type of metamorphosis. Life cycle starts with eggs and it moves towards within 4 to 5 days after hatching to larval stage. Larva will survive for 21 to 41 days in which it feeding voraciously on the grains with webbing activity. Further, in webbing, it goes for pupation for 10 to 14 days. After that, the adult brown color adult will emerge out. Adult longevity is more than 2 to 4 days. After that mating, female lays egg. Again, the life cycle starts with egg, and again it completed till the adult. Butter is required for the rearing of Corcyra cephalonica in laboratory. Wooden rearing box, mating chamber, media, crushed sorghum grains, yeast, sulfur. Refrigerator is also required. Other accessories like brush, honey, formaldehyde, cotton, plug, centrifuge. These are the required for the rearing of this Corcyra cephalonica. Feeding media of Corcyra cephalonica includes majorly jowar grains, which are very easily available nearby stores with low cost. Groundnut kernels also used as the source for these fats. Yeast is also required as a media ingredient, and this type of all ingredients are mixed with this Corcyra rearing box. Here we are using Corcyra eggs, fresh eggs, for the charging of the box or inoculation of the box. 0.3 cc means approximately 6 to 8 thousand eggs will be required for this charging of this box. These are the some photographs showing the ingredients. With the crushed jowar grains, only we have to make 2 to 3 pieces of jowar grains for the rearing purpose. Yeast powder should be added into these grains. Groundnut kernel, crushed groundnut kernel of near about 100 gram should be added. The Corcyra eggs should be sieved to remove the scales and the body parts of the Corcyra moth. And we have to first clean the Corcyra rearing box with the help of formaldehyde to give out, wash out, wipe out the all the contamination or the parasitic insect inside the box. Procedure for the rearing is having the following steps. The required quantity of sorghum grain or the media should be weighed on the weighing balance, and it should be with the core pieces. Crushed 100 gram of groundnut kernel should be mixed with the grains, and the box should be cleaned with ethyl alcohol or any other sanitizer. Add a 2.5 kg crushed grainy layering box, mix 100 gram crushed groundnut kernel and the other yeast and sulfur ingredient thoroughly. The ingredient should be poured gently, and one care should be taken that all the ingredients should be mixed well in the box, and we have to mixing with the help of the hand. Then to inoculate the eggs, the egg should be measured in a tube, approximately 0.3 cc eggs should be sorted out from the egg source, and these eggs should be gently tapped in the on the sieve. With the help of the sieve we can evenly distribute the small minute eggs. These are very minute, having very small size, should be uniformly placed on the box. After the mixing of all the ingredients, keep the box with the well labeled date of the inoculation. Date of inoculation should be written on the box. This box should be kept for 4 to 5 weeks for the to waiting the completing the life cycle of the Corcyra cephalonica. After that, after 4 to 5 weeks, after moth emergence will be started, and this continues for the 2 months hereafter. And moth should be collected during the morning hours only, because in morning hours moth are very inactive, which is very helpful to collect moth with the help of test tube. In morning we have to collect the test tube with moth with the test tube. Moth will be found behind the this box lid, and which can be easily collected in the test tube gently by hand. After that we have to transfer the moth to this Corcyra mating chamber or eggling chamber, where the conical shape flask is help to collect the all the laid eggs by female daily. In morning we can collect the eggs, fresh eggs, and we can use for the further needful. Also we have to provide the artificial diet for Corcyra cephalonica adults. This adult diet is made with the help of the sugar and honey solution. It should be replaced daily in morning. This is the life cycle which we will observe in the box. This is the larvae. After a few days the pupation stage will be observed, and after 45 days till 50 to 60 days we can observe this type of moths, and after that mating we can obtain the eggs from the mating chamber. Egg production collections, we have to take care. If we have large type of collection, large type of mass production room, then we have to use vacuum cleaner for the collection of the moth. We have to adjust the pressure of the vacuum cleaner, which should not be damage the adults while collection. Moth diet, adult diet of the Corcyra cephalonica should be kept separately in the breeding cages, but it should not be contaminated with any type of mold or fungus developing on this sugar syrup. The breeding cage is having 30 mm mesh size, which is very helpful for to naturally collection of the eggs, fresh eggs at the conical egg collection chamber. After 1 to 2 days in the moth start laying egg, were collected from the breeding cage and stored separately in refrigerator at with the help of this moisture absorbing material. We have to keep water in the bottom of this cage to avoid the entry of the ants in the mating chamber. This Corcyra cephalonica eggs are furtherly used for rearing of different parasites like trichogramma. For Corcyra cephalonica is a term as a good laboratory host or factious host for the rearing of this trichogramma chilonis, trichogramma bacteria, trichogramma japonicum, which are widely used as a potential biocontrol true egg parasite. It is also eggs are also used for the research purpose. Various biosis activity of the ovicidal effect can be done with the help of this Corcyra egg. These Corcyra eggs can be used for the mass production of EPN, which is very helpful. Preparation of the trichocard is possible, with the help of the trichocard we can use the various paste, that is bollworm, sorghum, shoot borer. This is all about the use of mass production of the Corcyra cephalonica in laboratory. Thank you.